So back in the summer, I was invited out to do some mudlarking with Alex and Gail, aka the Northern Mudlarks. Later on, I'll be creating some Christmas tree decorations inspired by some of the finds we make. Also, Christmas comes early for some lucky subscribers as I reveal the winners of the competition.
All right, mud lovers, how you doing? I'm with my mudlark buddy Stu today.
Good morning.
And we are up north in Berwick, and we're going to be meeting up with the lovely ladies who are the Northern Mudlarks. We've got our metal detectors ready. We've got one to share with them, so we're going to be detecting the glorious foreshore down there. Some lovely old bridges, loads of lovely history. So let's get some luck in the muck. Good smiles, Jay.
Berwick-upon-Tweed is the northernmost town in England and is situated on the mouth of the River Tweed, where we'll be meeting the Northern Mudlarks, who have their own excellent YouTube channel. Links are in the description below. Due to its proximity to Scotland, Berwick has been fought over for centuries. I wonder if we'll find anything relating to those battles today.
As you can tell, I'm with the lovely ladies of the Northern Mudlarks, Alex and Gail. They kindly invited us onto this beautiful piece of foreshore today, and we're going to go metal detecting and hopefully find some treasure that has been lost for a very long time. So thanks, ladies, for inviting us along. Oh, Stu's here as well. I say you've already seen him already, but
Thank you for coming along.
That's all right. Yeah. Oh, pleasure.
On a beautiful day.
It is. Look, you've got a lovely, lovely bridge in the background there. All the stuff that could have fallen from that. We've got a castle behind us. Loads of history. Berwick has got all sorts of history, including battlefields and lots of trade coming up the river. So hopefully we'll find some good stuff.
Yeah,
it's got some luck in the muck.
Some luck in the muck.
We have chosen to begin our mudlark below the ruins of Berwick Castle. Now this is Crown Foreshore Estate, therefore detecting is permitted. Please check you have landowner's permission before you carry out any metal detecting yourself. Built in the 1120s by the Scottish King David, it went through numerous custodians until 1464, when the English invaded and Ebid IV took power. However, in the 1500s, due to the construction of modern ramparts around Berwick, which we'll be visiting later to search, the castle fell into disrepair. Even its stones were taken and used for other buildings. And in 1847, the Great Hall of Berwick Castle was demolished to make way for Berwick-upon-Tweed Railway Station on the Northern British Railway, which is a bridge you can see above.
Testing over the pound coin. Alex is using my trusted gold bug. This has found loads of goodies, so it's a very capable machine. So you've got a nice crisp sound there, so that's basically what you're looking for. That's sort of between sort of 50 and 90 is a good signal, and you can notice how it's sort of, that's iron or something, something miserable, and the numbers go down.
Right, okay.
So the higher the number, generally the better the conductivity. So,
Great. Cool. I've got a good feeling about this.
Cool.
It's an Edward I hammered silver half penny, and it was struck in Berwick, so I thought it was appropriate to bring it and show you.
That's exactly, that's awesome. We can use it as a demonstration to get an ear out for what sort of signals we're listening out for. So if you get a number similar to that, what number does it give you, Alex?
Around 60, 61.
There we go. So if you find one at that signal, there's a reasonable chance it's going to be that. Or probably a piece of aluminium from a Coke can or something like that.
Oh, yeah, pulled out.
Yeah. But we've got to dig them all, get all the signals up. Let's give it a crack. Great big bolt. It's alright,
It's the first find. It's something to improve on. Well, I did actually need a detector to find this, but look, a little 303. Been fired, so I can keep that. Probably from World War II. Yeah, pretty nice. Might be able to make out a maker's mark on that. Cool. So behind me is a castle, and there's actually some store entrance cavities there that we use to obviously take stuff on board. I've just detected a little caster. Come and take a look. I don't know if you can see that there, but that's a wheel of an old caster. I'll tap some of this rust off in there and get a proper look at it. Must have a bit of age to it, all that crud stuck to it. Probably Victorian era, that sort of age. Oh, Gail's found the same wheel as I have. That caster. It's pretty cool. You gonna take it, Gail?
I'm not sure. I'll have to think about that one.
Well, I've got something to show you anyway. Do you want to have a look?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, cool. So, look, found this lock.
Oh, wow. Oh yeah, that's cool.
Maybe it was a lock on the old castle there.
Yeah, it was off the treasure chest.
It
definitely
was, but you can definitely make out the double-sided.
The escutcheon, yeah.
Yeah. On both sides, that one's a bit crudded up, but that could be brass, a little bit there.
Yeah, could be.
Well, there is. You can see a little bit of gold colour coming through.
Oh yeah, that's strange.
Oh, it's just the brass, isn't it?
Oh yeah, it is.
That would clean up quite nicely.
It would. That might be a nice thing.
Now, I don't want to take this all the way back in my car, all the way back down south. So would you reckon you might want to take that and clean it up for me?
I will take that and I'll clean it up and cool. Then you can see it in its full glory.
Fantastic. Thank you. Yeah. Well, Gail struck gold colour. That's really interesting. God, that's really giving off a nice beaming, gleaming, blingy colour.
Yeah, it is, isn't it?
What do you think it is?
No idea. Heavy. I think that might be lead or tin around the outside.
Cool, imagine if it is gold.
Oh, yeah.
That'd be awesome.
Very heavy.
Yeah, it looks like it's been like hit against as well, doesn't it? So maybe it was used to take a bit of a brunt of, you
like
know, some
the
abuse.
Front of a boat or something.
Yeah, I reckon you're right. It almost looks like it's part of a pot, doesn't it, or something, but
yeah,
strange. Yeah, most likely brass, unfortunately, but you never know. I don't see how they would use gold in that such a crude form, would they?
No.
Unless it's part of some ordnance, perhaps.
Yeah, that's what I thought as well, another possibility. But with being cool. In that mud, I suppose it's kept its brightness.
Yeah, it will, the old anaerobic mud. Yeah. There's no little deterioration. What if that's fingerprints down the side of it?
That's what I thought.
Or just tool marks.
Yeah,
a bit of a mystery find.
It is.
Let us know if you find out what it is.
I will.
Well, I got all excited there for a second. I thought I found a coin of age, but it turns out to be a 1p. Very worn. Never mind. So I've just found this little lead ball. Could be a pistol shot. Pretty cool if it was. Fired back in the day from that castle up there. Nice signal there. 21. Oh! No, can that be a coin? Oh, I want to shout out to them. I've got a coin, but they're so far away. That's really cool. Yep, looks to be a, I think it's a half penny, halfpenny, no, or a penny. See if I can give it a quick swirl. Can't see straight away what this coin is, but you know, it's got a little rim on there I'm not familiar with. But I can definitely think I can see, it definitely looks like Britannia on that side there, look. I'm going with probably a Victorian penny. But it's very thin. Nice! What a coin! Happy with that? Now this definitely feels more basketball-like. It's much more irregular, so it's got a bit of age to it. Nice. Pretty cool bit of history that come from the castle. So I just set up this ring-shaped object, quite possibly from like a medieval belt or some kind of belt attachment that would hang keys and things off of, or anything for that matter, purses. Yeah, it's quite crude. It's pretty cool. Also, I found a piece of this piece of pottery here. Not sure on the age on that. Might be post-medieval redware. A little pot with some decoration on, so that's quite nice, but I think I'll leave that here. Just thought I'd show you.
We interrupt this broadcast for an impromptu Christmas craft project.
So another common find we have a lot of is these, snail. So another common find that we find a lot of are pottery shards. Now they come in the form of plates, mugs, bowls, you name it. Whatever was made using pottery, there are shards. So there's some really cool ones here that I picked up. So what I want to do is make something quite Christmassy, because we're coming up to that time of the year. So what I thought I'd do is make a Christmas bauble using mosaics. Now, I've had a good think about this, and I've gone through some different ideas about using tennis balls, but I found this, which it's a toilet ball thingy. You know, when you flush a toilet, can't think what it's called, but I found it, and I've taken off the lip there. There's a lip that was protruding, and I've keyed it up, ready to add some ceramics, some pottery, some shards to the outside, and then hopefully grout it over and see how it looks. Don't know how it's going to turn out. I've come outside because I know it's going to make a mess, and I've covered my table with a towel just so that it's easy to clear up all the shards later. So the sort of thing we're going to be doing is choosing objects which are slightly round, hopefully, so that they work better on the curved surface. So it's just a case, hopefully, of nipping. I mean, I quite like that as it is, but I want her. I want that female there looking quite regal. I'm just thinking, do I cut them square or do I just do them higgledy-piggledy? Not sure yet. I might just have a little go at cutting and see what sort of shapes that I like. I like this one. I'm not sure they're going to be completely square, but yeah, you just sort of cut them like that until you're happy with kind of shape and size. Right, I've decided to go higgledy-piggledy. I was going to make them all square, but I don't think that's going to be possible. So I think I'll just kind of make up as I go along, glue them on, and see where it takes me. So that's the first one, just apply a little bit of grout, pop it on there. There we go. So there we go, a little way in, looking really good actually. Happy with that. It's quite tricky to get the bits to fit on a bevel, so I've had to use a sort of a grinder to help create a bevel, but looking all right. It's going to take quite a while, I think, to cover the whole thing and then grout it. I might have to do it in stages, let it dry and then come back to it later. So it'll be quite a time consuming project, but hopefully it will look good when it's finished. There we go. Only another 40 more to do. Well, here we go, halfway through, just come back the next day just to carry it on. Yeah, got some other pieces of shards to put on there, some other interesting cool bits and bobs. I've made a little hook that goes through there, and I found some other metal work that I can use to finish off the finial area. And so just, it's a case of covering this side now. It's a bummer because it takes quite a while to dry, so you have to kind of stop for hours and let it dry. But if you look previously on a video with my hovercraft history hunters, I found this piece which is really cool, so I put that on the bottom there, fits perfectly, and yeah, it looks nice. So that's my little base, so I'm just going to fill in the rest of the gaps now. Not too far to go, looking really good. And another possible musket ball. Right, half time. So we found a few bits and bobs, musket balls, a few coins and some other bits and bobs. So now we're gonna check out the area by the quayside, because Alex tells me that's where we're gonna find even more treasure.
Yeah, that's where it's all at, the quayside.
Let's go! Having a quick bite to eat? Oh, cheeky. Well, here we are, location number two. A couple of bridges and some good history. So, see if we can get some more luck in the muck. Yes, silver! 20p. Ah, oh, cute little button. Alex, your fans are up there.
Okay, so Si has found himself a sword. Look at that.
Off with your head. It does look quite enticing though, doesn't it?
Yeah, it does. What is it actually?
It's probably a metal stake for a fence post.
Oh, okay.
To keep the sheep in.
That's a little bit more mundane, but never mind.
But I quite like wielding my sword.
Yeah. There's always a bit of clay pipe.
Again, we interrupt this broadcast for another Christmas craft project.
So, there we go. Gal found a nice little pipe stem. I've been collecting them as well from the Thames because there comes a time when you just want to make something from these things because they're so tactile. They make a beautiful noise when they jingle jangle. I've done wind chimes and bracelets and things like that. But now I want to do something a little bit Christmassy. Yes, sorry, I've said the C word. I know it's only November, but I've had an idea and I want to make a tree ornament using these. So let's give it a go and you'll see if you can work out what I'm going to make by the end of this little section. Well, there we go. That probably took about 20 minutes to make that. I'm really happy with it, actually. It's really cool. These little pipes seem to still move as well. They rotate so you can sort of display whatever side you want if one's dirty or a bit grubby. But these are in great condition anyway. These are all river worn. I had to shorten a few just because it didn't quite fit, but just rounded, sanded off the edges to make them look river worn so they fit perfectly. But yeah, most of them are as they were found, just folded over these edges there to stop them from coming out. But how cool is that? The Thames snowflake made of clay pipe stems. Right, well, I'm going to put this on my Ebid store because I want to share it with you guys, so hopefully you'll be able to navigate your way over there using the link in the description below, and you could even own it, put it on your Christmas tree nice and early, ready for Christmas. Location number 3, or maybe 4 of the day. Here we go, look. Oh, plenty of land to detect. Oh, you're already here. What are the chances? Yep, time for the big coil.
Yep, Simon's putting his big coil on, he's getting serious now.
These ramparts were first built in the 1500s, but then later updated in the 17th and 18th century and became the focus of defence for Berwick from invasion, including the threat from Napoleon. There are still cannons on top of the rampart, which date to the 19th century. Hopefully we'll find something of historical interest down below. Everywhere you go, there's always a copper nail.
Oh, I love a copper nail.
You like a copper nail?
I love copper nails. Yeah, we love copper nails.
Yeah, you can take it then. It's my gift to you. You gave me a really nice pendant. I'll give you a copper nail. Sounds like a fair exchange.
Fair trade, yeah.
Sounds like a good signal.
Yeah, actually. Seems
huge though. Oh, it's big, yeah. It's probably a drain cover.
Well, actually, there were loads of cannons up here on these walls, but you can see where they used to be. They're still up there. Some of them are still up there.
Oh, really?
This might be
I must have found a cannonball. That'd be awesome. So Gail kindly gave me this lovely pen. So Gail kindly made this lovely little pendant for me, a little footprint in a silver blob, for a bit, want of a better word. But how cool is that? So it's going to be added to my little collection of trinkets. So yeah, really happy with that. And to exchange, I'll give Alex a copper now.
Well, I can make a little necklace out of it or something. That's lovely. It's cute, one. Isn't it?
I found a quite a large one, a large copper nail, probably about that long, maybe bigger.
Oh, really? But you can make it into a bracelet.
Yeah,
yeah,
I'll
you
do
can
that.
Make it into a little bangle. We've done it in the past, so yeah, definitely.
Oh, cool. Actually, did you do one with, did it have a little chain between the two
yeah,
ends?
Yeah, yeah. So we found a bit, we used a bit of old chain that we found, a bit of old copper chain, and we curved the nail.
Yeah.
And we made a really cool bracelet with a little skull and crossbone charm on it.
Oh, brilliant.
Like a little pirate's bracelet.
As you can see, we find loads of nails on the Thames foreshore, but I particularly like these two. First, this is quite an old one, it's square and it's been squared off at the top. I think it's called rose tip. That's really nice. And then the longest ever copper nail. Look at the size of that one. So not usually a nail collector, but sometimes you've got to appreciate the craftsmanship and the pure joy you get from these old nails.
Once again, we interrupt this broadcast for one final Christmas craft project.
So, if you're wondering what I'm doing with these copper nails, the old ship nails from the Thames, well, I'm going to be making another tree ornament in the shape of a star this time. So three pieces of Christmas tree hanging ornaments for you to enjoy. So I've got some copper wire that I'm going to feed through these. Don't know how it's going to look yet, but like with everything that I do, I just like to experiment and see where it takes me. Some of these are copper and some of these are brass, interestingly, so maybe I should do copper brass and I now feed the second line around as it needs it to secure it halfway there. Well, I was struggling trying to get this on whilst it was round, so I've had to put them on flat and then hopefully I can bend them round. Still very fiddly, so rather than subject you to all that, this is what it looks like when it was finally done. Basically, I've pulled these round and hopefully that will flex with it. We'll end up there somewhere. We'll end up with the right look soon. Right, well, that idea looked a bit naff and I didn't like it, so I'm trying a different angle. I'm not going to waste these though, these are great. However, I'll only need one hole out of all six nails because I'm going to put it around a marble instead, because I didn't think the previous one looked very star-like. It looked more like a gothic spider web, which I didn't really think was very Christmassy. But marbles are quite cute and I think I glue these on there with a bit of epoxy resin, good stuff this, and I reckon that should hold nicely and then it can hang from one of these holes. Let's try it like that. So now you know that I can make a mistake or change my ideas. Well, I'm so much happier with that than I was with the previous attempt. Something completely different, and I like it because it's more minimalist. There's no wires hanging around too much, apart from there will be one wire coming at the top, and it looks kind of unusual and also quite, it's got the character of the nails and the character of the marble, all Thames found stuff, but just arranged in a pretty cool star fashion. So yeah, happy with that. Let's see how all three of them look up on the tree. So I hope you like these guys. I think they turned out really well. They took a long time to make, believe me, and I want to share them with you. So if you fancy bidding on them and treating yourself or a loved one maybe for Christmas, then head on over to my Ebid page and have a cheeky bid.
That's one like.
This one's are having a good old gulp at what gal's up to. Hopefully one won't come up and bite her on the bum if she's not looking.
Well, my theory was people might have chucked stuff off this big turret, and they did, and it's a silver coin, but it's only a 10p. Oh, so gal's found a nice piece of
it's carnelian agate.
Agate.
And it's got sort of a chalcedony like outer shell on it there, and beautiful carnelian on the inside.
Brilliant. So you're going to take that?
Yeah.
And what would you do with it?
Hopefully polish it up someday.
Yeah. Have you got a special grinding wheel that does that?
Not yet, no. They're very expensive.
Oh, right.
But we do it by hand.
Oh, really? Well, with sandpaper and stuff?
Yeah, different grades.
Wicked, I can't wait to see that. It might take you a few years to sand that down, but
it's one of our videos, we're doing it. So.
Oh, nice one. Look out for that.
Yeah.
Yeah, stick them up. It's a bullet. 9mm, maybe. Might be a bit small actually for that. Yeah, it doesn't say anything on the bottom. Wonder if they're having much luck in the muck over there.
Okay, so the cannonball turned out to be not a cannonball, and we have no idea what that is. If anyone has any idea what that is,
Or was,
yeah. It's got two holes in the bottom and it's very sharp. So I'm going to leave it here.
Flat on the other side.
Yeah, flat on the other side. It's a mystery. Spiky iron mystery.
The detecting duo.
You found anything?
Not a great deal.
Neither have we.
But it's all about trying.
It's been a learning experience.
You enjoying it?
Yeah, it's been quite good.
We
found 1p.
Oh, there we go. 1p richer. Well, thanks for inviting up, ladies. It was a pleasure, and we absolutely loved our time up here. So, thanks for inviting us. So if you like some of this, check out their channel, Northern Mudlarks. Subscribe and like and comment, and hopefully we'll see you on the next mudventure. See you later, mud lovers. Well, look, here I am on the foreshore. Not really, just a little trick. Anyway, I just want to thank everyone for entering the competition, and let's not hang around. Let's find out who the winner was of that fantastic jewellery that Wendy made.
First prize is the wonderful bracelet, followed by the pendant, and then finally the earrings. So what we need to do is just put in the URL of the video, put in our hashtag, the magic word was shared. So thanks everyone for sharing the video, or any video for that matter. Please keep doing so in the future if you want to tell your mates. A whopping 482 of you have entered the competition, so good luck everyone, and we'll find out who wins right now. We just have to press that start button and we'll see a few names rolling along. Will it be you? The winner is Weeby Cats. Well done, Weeby, if that is your real name. Thank you very much. You are the proud winner of the bracelet. Congratulations. Right, okay, next winner. Winner number two for the pendant is Mika06V8. I'm pretty sure that's not your real name. Maybe Mika is. Anyway, congratulations to you. You have won the pendant. Fantastic. Okay, finally, one final winner. This is for the earrings, the beautiful garnet earrings.
The winner is Cindy Katz. Thank you very much, Cindy, and everyone who entered and commenting and sharing. I do read all the comments, so keep them coming. And if you weren't lucky enough to win, please pop over to Wendy's Folksy store and get your Christmas orders in now. More competitions will be running in the future, so please subscribe and tap that notification bell so you don't miss a thing.